Now I'd like to talk about a topic that is sometimes confusing for students, and that is the topic of statistical significance. Statistical significance in the area of statistics has a very specialized meaning, and it's kind of counterintuitive. It doesn't really fit with what we normally think of in terms of significance. So in everyday life, we use the word significant to talk about things that are important to us, things that are large or sizable, things that are meaningful. In statistics, the phrase statistical significance has none of these meanings. I'm going to write on the other side what significance does mean. Significance does mean that we've rejected the null hypothesis. Significance also means that our results are not likely due to chance or sampling error. Notice that this and this are just two different ways of saying the same thing. The important point is to note when you see the word statistical significance, it doesn't mean that our results were important, that they were large or sizable, or that they were even meaningful. All it means is that the results are probably not due to chance. In other words, we've ruled out random chance or sampling error as an explanation of our results. That's an important point to keep in mind. So how do we know if the results of a research study were meaningful or important? One thing we have to know is what was measured. What were the variables? Did the variables have practical or social importance, or even theoretical importance? Obviously, if our variables do not have any importance in terms of practical application, social issues, or theory, then clearly it doesn't matter what the results were, the results are not important. Another thing to consider in assessing the meaningfulness of results is the effect size. How large were the results? That doesn't mean that small results are not important, or large results are necessarily important, but effect size is considered when assessing the meaningfulness of results. And it's possible for even very small effect sizes to be very important. A final thing to consider is, can we rule out random chance for the results? In other words, can we rule out sampling error as an explanation? Now, this doesn't guarantee that our results are important, but it goes a long way into helping us assess the rest of the importance. Next, we need to know, can we rule out alternative explanations for the results? These are those dreaded lurking variables we've been talking about before. So putting this all together, this gives you a rough guideline of assessing whether the results of a study are meaningful. What was measured? How large was the effect? Could we rule out random chance as an explanation? And can we rule out lurking variables as explanations for the results?